So the second parish is also in the Archdiocese of Kampala.
Yes.
Okay. So no, there you.
No, that is the third one, because third I started one. With the one.
Yes.
Where I spent 2 years. Then I went to another one. Mm-hmm. Spent again 2 years. Then that was the third one. Mm-hmm. So I remember it was on Easter Monday.
Yes.
When I decided to go to the Archbishop, mm-hmm. and they say Happy Easter, because for me there was no problem with the Archbishop.
Yes.
So I went to his residence. As soon as I opened the door, I said in a very nice, friendly voice, "Have you packed up?" She said, "Packing up, going where?"
Yes, yes.
I thought it was joking.
Yes, yes.
She said, "Yes. And you see, they have come here, and they have asked you to go and teach in the major seminary." I became cold, because I've never thought of going to a major seminary teach. Mm. So I had to, and I was given only 2 weeks.
To pack up. To go to major seminary.
Yeah, you know, we priests give promise obedience. There was no way I could say no.
Yes, yes.
So I packed up in fear and the tremble, as St. Paul said, I came to you in fear and tremble.
Yes,
so did I go
yes.
to the major seminary very uncomfortably.
Mm-hmm. So you were formators at the seminary?
Yes. Okay. I was specifically a general spiritual director in the major seminary. But I wasn't prepared for it.
Yes, yes.
Then after 2 years, I was sent to Rome to study spirituality mm-hmm. at Gregorian University.
Okay.
Which I did to mm-hmm. doctorate.
Mm-hmm.
Came back to Uganda 1978.
Mm-hmm.
I was appointed as general spiritual director to the theological major seminary.
Okay.
So there I was teaching, prophesied after some 7 years there.
Oh, it's quite a long time.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
I was started as general spiritual director, then as director of the seminary. Then in 1985, mm-hmm. I was appointed a bishop.
Okay.
Again, that was the end of...
So before you become bishop, the last appointment was really as a spiritual, you know... Yeah, right? For this major
spiritual
seminary.
Formation.
Yes, spiritual. So how many seminaries you have at that time?
You see, we have two national philosophical major seminaries.
Okay.
And two... theological major seminary.
Okay.
You could say in the major theological seminaries, there are about at least an average of 150 major seminarians coming from all the country. You know, we have 18 dioceses.
18?
Yes.
That's quite big.
Yeah. And also the same thing with the philosophy. Philosophy, there are more than that. Because now we feel that the number is too big, we would like to start a third philosophical major seminary. Mm-hmm. Our challenges are two.
Mm-hmm.
We don't have personnel, we don't have priests who are prepared to study the third philosophical seminary.
Yes.
And also we don't have the construction done already. It is a problem of personnel and a problem of money, otherwise we should have started a third one already. And 1970, when I became a bishop in 1985,
mm-hmm.
1997, I was appointed first as auxiliary bishop at the Archdiocese of Kampala.
Mm-hmm.
In 1997, I was appointed to a new diocese as the first one to find it.
What's the name of this new diocese?
The name of the diocese is Lugazi.
Lugazi
diocese mm-hmm. what it was a part of Kampala Archdiocese.
Ah, okay.
And as I an auxiliary bishop, I used to go to these parishes.
Okay.
So I knew them. And one of the parishes, I was a parish priest before I was appointed to the seminary. So I knew the people.
I'm very interested, you know, because you said you come from a family who are very, very religious, right? So where did your parents learn their faith?
Well, my father was a convert at the age, not a convert, but he was a catechumen, was baptized as an adult.
Okay.
Because his father was died before he was born.
Okay.
My mother was baptized as a child, yes. And my father knew faith maybe when he was about 14 or 7 years, yes. Between 8 and 14.
Yes.
But he grasped the little he could mm-hmm. get. He didn't have much education. But I would say by the grace of God, yeah, he took to heart the faith.
Mm-hmm.
And he brought me to church for baptism
okay.
at a very early age time. Mm-hmm. I think okay. just a month after my birth,
yes.
I was baptized.
Mm-hmm.
And he chose a very good godmother, godfather.
Yes.
Our home was far from the parish.
Yes.
So when I started schooling,
mm-hmm.
I went to my godfather family.
Okay.
And this was so near from the church.
Yes.
Every day we recite a morning prayers, evening prayers together. And he allowed me to go to serve, allowed me to go to practice in the choir.
Yes.
This helped me a lot. My godfather was by far better than my father.
Oh, yeah.
As mm-hmm. a Catholic.
Yes, yes.
So all this helped me. You say it is the hand of God.
Yes.
For you, you see it easily. But yes. For me...
You don't understand
at the time. Now I just admire now. But by then, you see a lot of surprising burdens mm-hmm. coming up. Eh? After 2 years, it was not all that very common.
Yes,
to
yes.
become a parish priest.
Yes.
And a parish priest where I had more than 75 chapels.
Okay.
And each chapel could be parish by itself.
Yes.
I was alone there using a motorcycle on rough roads.
Yes.
It wasn't all that easy.
Okay.
And I tell you, to go to the seminary, major seminary,
mm-hmm.
mind you, after Vatican II, there was a lot of revolution in the church.
Okay.
Even the seminary formation all over the world.
Yes.
So in that turmoil, it was not all that easy again.
Yes.
Because
yes.
tradition was more or less put aside.
Yes, yes.
And the lifestyle was becoming somehow very new.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, some misinterpreted Vatican II.
Mm-hmm.
They went to extreme.
Yes.
After Vatican II, maybe 10 years after, from the end,
yes.
the church lost so many vocations, yeah. lost so many priests, so many mm-hmm. religious.
Mm-hmm.
So in that turmoil,
mm-hmm.
it wasn't all that easy to give a solid formation
mm-hmm.
of the prospective pastors of God.
Okay.
As you know, it was all over the world.
Mm-hmm.
Definitely Vatican II
yes.
brought about a lot of changes. Some are positive. Others are questionable.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So in all this time, to be in a leadership position,
yes.
it wasn't all that easy. But by God's grace, here I am.
Yes.
You know, I celebrated 50 years of priesthood last December.
Yes, 50th year?
As a priest.
Imagine.
December,
golden year,
last
right? You celebrate
year.
Your golden jubilee.
Yes, yes.
Yeah.
So when I look back, I see a priest who gave me first communion.
Okay.
Not at the parish. But you know, in that time, priests would go to one place far away from the parish.
Yes.
Stay there for 2 or 3 days.
Yes.
And that's where I went with my mother. I was a very small kid.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And usually they would prepare children for first communion.
Yes.
My mother didn't bother, didn't know anything about it. So other children were being prepared.
You're not
they were being questioned.
Yes.
For me, I was just playing. And near from the father. Maybe yes. I was a spoiled son.
Yes.
And my mother felt a bit embarrassed.
Yes.
Because the way I was playing near the father, it wasn't good. So
yes.
he wanted to beat me, but he was afraid because
yes.
the father was there.
Yes.
And after asking those who had been prepared,
yes.
he called me
yeah.
when it was getting dark. Mm-hmm. He put some questions.
Yes.
I don't know. I don't remember anything of what he asked me.
Mm-hmm.
But my mother told me
yes.
that I answered correctly and I qualified to receive the first Holy Communion. So I received it.
Yes. Mm.
Another surprise I had that 2 years later,
yes.
when I was at school, mm-hmm. this father had been transferred
to another place,
to another parish.
Okay.
But then he came to say hello to his friends.
Yes.
All children went to greet him.
Yes.
He picked me up. He called me by the name yes. of my father.
Yeah.
I was shocked.
Yes.
I said, how? And I went back home, I said, Mother, that priest called me by yes. my name. Who yes. is he? How did he come to know me?
Yes.
Then she told me the whole story.
Yeah.
And that father becomes my first parish priest.
Yeah.
So for me, the first 2 years were the honeymoon of yes. my priesthood.
We will continue our discussions sa pagbabalik po ng Poverty Night with Elvira.